Good morning children, how are you? Today we are going to discuss new topic, that is the second chapter, social studies. See, look at the board and chapter 2, globe, model of the earth. So globe, we know very well about the globe. It is the one of the model of the earth, true model of the earth. And see here, when we are observing the world map and the Pacific Ocean, the importance of the Pacific Ocean, the biggest ocean in the world. Pacific Ocean, when we are seeing on the world map, it is east also located and west also located. And but actually there is no two Pacific Oceans, there is only one Pacific Ocean. When we are observing the globe, when we are taking the globe, the Pacific Ocean and located in the particular area. When we are going to see on the world map, it is west side also located and east side also located. When we are folded, that the Pacific Ocean is located in the one place. See, like that. And satellites also given the a good imaginations about the imaginary pictures and real pictures also we see the globe. See here, when we are going to discussing this chapter, the first we are going to learn latitudes and longitudes, land, water, continents, oceans, and northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, and what is western hemisphere and what is eastern hemisphere. And these points we are going to discuss today. See, the first one here, latitudes. And latitudes are the imaginary lines. So what is latitudes? Latitudes are imaginary lines, not a real lines. So here the latitudes horizontally draw on the globe. Horizontal, the means horizontal. And here horizontal means this is horizontal. Okay, see. And latitudes also imaginary lines, and which are vertically draw on the globe. Vertical means a straight line. See here, and land and water, how much land covered on the globe and how much water covered on the globe. See here, these land is divided into 7 land masses. We know very well that is the continents. And water bodies also divided into the 5 water masses. So here it is also covered on the globe. So let us and see here, northern hemisphere. And what is the northern hemisphere means? 0 degrees. 0 degrees latitude means equator. And 0 degrees from latitude from and 90 degrees north pole, that part is called northern hemisphere. From the 0 degrees latitude to and 90 degrees south pole is called the southern hemisphere. So like that, western hemisphere also is there. And here 90 degrees north to and 0 degrees equator, that part, eastern part, is called the eastern hemisphere. At the same time, and 0 degrees north pole to and south pole and 90 degrees and 0 degrees to equator, it is called the western hemisphere, northern hemisphere and western hemisphere. See here, let us, we are going to discuss in first two, I am going to take the latitudes. See, latitudes are the imaginary lines and which are drawn on the globe. See, look at the board, here pictures, and these are the which are drawn on the globe, and this is the horizontal lines, horizontal lines. See here, and this is the longest latitude, longest latitude, and 0 degrees latitude is called the longest latitude. It is also called the equator. So it is located, it is, what is the importance of the equator? It is divided at two equal halves, equal parts, that is the northern hemisphere, from the 0 degrees to and 90 degrees north. So this part is called northern hemisphere, and 0 degrees to and 90 degrees south pole, this part is called and southern hemisphere. See here, the important of the latitudes here, 0 degrees latitude, and it is called the equator, and 23.5 degrees north latitude, it is called the Tropic of Cancer. It is also passed through on the India, middle of the India. So India also divided by the Tropic of Cancer, North India and South India. See, another important latitude, and 66.5 degrees north latitude is called the Arctic Circle. What is this? Arctic Circle. And next, this is the north latitudes. These are all called the north latitudes. And here, these are all which are the, at the same time we are going to take the south part also, which are drawn in the south part. These latitudes are called the southern latitudes. And here 23.5 degrees south latitude is called Tropic of Capricorn, and 66.5 degrees south latitude is called and Antarctica Circle. So these are the circles. See here, latitudes are imaginary lines and circles, these are circles. So these are the important latitudes. And how many latitudes are there? There are here the 181 latitudes. Here one, how many latitudes? 181. See here, from the south side 90 and 90 plus 90, north side 90 and is equal to 180, and plus one equator, the total 181 latitudes. And I hope you are getting the idea about the latitudes. See, listen here, latitudes are the imaginary lines. Okay, what are imaginary lines? Which are drawn on the globe in the horizontally. So when we are seeing on the map with the help of the latitudes, we are able to find out the particular place, or India or Andhra Pradesh or any Japan or America. If you are taking any place, we are able to find out on the map. So I hope you are understanding. And latitudes, what is latitude, children? Here latitudes are the imaginary lines. Okay, see here, and next one is the longitudes. Longitudes means these are the imaginary lines. Longitudes also called imaginary lines. Here totally, and we know very well western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. See here, and these are the vertically lines. Vertically lines here, from the, these are drawn on the globe, vertically lines, and this is 0 degrees longitude. So like that, here so many longitudes are there, and this is the west part of the globe, this is the east part of the globe, and the west side 180 longitudes, and at the same time east side also 180 longitudes, and 180 longitudes, and total 360 longitudes. How many longitudes? 360. And here the importance of the 0 degrees longitude. What is the importance of the 0 degrees longitude? 0 degrees longitude, and it is also called the Greenwich longitude. Why 0 degrees longitude is called the Greenwich longitude? See here, this 0 degrees longitude passed through on the London. The Greenwich is the place which is located in the London. So here, 1884, some of the geologists, they are given the name to the 0 degrees longitude. It is a suitable to call the Greenwich longitude, and it is also called the prime meridian. So what is the another name of the 0 degrees longitude? One, it has the 0 degrees longitude, and at the same time it is also called the Greenwich longitude, and it is also called the prime meridian, and meridians also is there. These longitude also called the meridians. Okay, children, see, listen here, the total how many 360 longitudes are there. So west side, west hemisphere means this is the western hemisphere, this is the eastern hemisphere. The total longitudes are the 360 longitudes. So that is the, what is the importance here? So latitudes, we are able to find out the particular place. At the same time, here we are going to take the longitudes here. We are finding the time and the climate. So that is the important, we are able to find the timings also. For example, I am going to say one example. See, sun, you are learning in the previous chapter, celestial bodies. The sun, one of the star, and which is the center of the solar system. So like that here, Earth also one of the planet which is revolves around itself, and at the same time it is also revolved around the sun. This is the one of the all celestial bodies from the rotated around the sun. So here, this is the, when we are going to take the latitudes, how we are going to count the timings here. For example, the day has, how much time the day have? 24 hours. How it is counted. And here, the sun rays falls on the earth. The sun rays falls on the earth. See here, when the sun rays falls on the earth, the sun rays travel one longitude to another longitude, it will be take the 4 minutes. So here, how many longitudes here? 360 longitudes are. And each one take the 4 minutes for the travel of sun rays. So totally 360, it is multiplied by 4, and 1440 minutes will be taken by the travel of sun rays. So totally it was 1440 divided by the 60, and it was cancelled by the 24 times. So that is the 24 hours for a day. We are going to counting that. So listen here, one is latitude and another one longitude. These are two are the imaginary lines. See, and these we are using the finding the place, and we are using the time and the climate also. And when the latitudes and the longitudes connected, for example, we are going to take here, and these are the vertical lines, longitudes, and here this is also one of the longitude, and here this is the latitude. When the latitude and the longitude cross and make a box, it is called the grid. What is this called? And this box is called grid. And when we are observing the, or when we are finding the place on the world map, or India map, or Andhra Pradesh map, or districts maps, we are using the latitudes, longitudes, and finding the particular grid, we are able to find the place on the map. So I hope you are understanding the latitudes and the longitudes. See children, and the textbook second chapter, every student should read the chapter 2. Textbook reading is the essential, and I should give the extra homework also. And we will meet next class.